Hello everybody, this is going to be a short tutorial on how to install Learning with Texts. If you want to know what Learning with Texts is or how it works, you can check this video up here somewhere. But yeah, in this video we're going to see how to install it because it's not that complicated, but it does require of a few steps. Just in case, there's going to be a link in the description where you can see this page where all the instructions are detailed clearly. You just have to follow each step, so that's what we're going to do in this video. There's three things that you need to download to use Learning with Texts. The first one is Visual C++. This is a Microsoft tool. Everything is going to be in the description. Again, you can find the links down there. But once you open the first link, you need to scroll down, choose your language, and simply click on download. Then here you need to choose the option that says 86. So this one, you make sure it's checked, and then you click on next, and that's going to download it. The second thing you need is EasyPHP. This is the program that lets you host your own server on your PC so that you can use Learning with Texts. Once you open the second link in the description, you're going to scroll down and click here where it says Dev Server 17.0. Once you click there, the program is going to download automatically. And then the last thing you need is Learning with Texts itself. You can find it again in the description. Once you open the link, you need to click here where it says Download Latest Version, and it will automatically download too. So here we have the three things that we're going to need. So let's go ahead and install Visual C++. You just click on Run. And then I have this installed already. In your case, it's probably going to say install. You just simply click on next until it's finished installing. It's a really straightforward installation. The second thing we need to install is EasyPHP. So again, we open it, we click on run. We can choose English or French. Then here we can select the folder where it's going to be installed. I recommend just leaving the default folder, but you can choose anywhere else on your computer. Just make sure you remember where you installed it because we're going to need to access these files later. You just click on next. You can create a desktop icon and you click on next, install. And now this is going to install EasyPHP. I'm going to pause the recording until it's done. So now that it's done installing, we can just uncheck this. We don't need to launch the program yet, and we can click on finish. And now we go back to the third file we downloaded, right click, and then choose extract here. This will give us a few more files. We don't need the text files, but this one, LYT with the version, you are going to copy it into another folder that you're going to create called LYT, like this. Now you open the folder and again, you right-click it and extract here. This is going to extract a bunch of files and you can delete the original zip file if you want to. Now what you need to do is to go to the directory where you installed Dev Server or EasyPHP. So if you created a desktop icon when you installed it, you can just right click it, choose properties, and then click on open file location. Now you have to locate this folder and open it, and then you're going to copy this folder that we created called LYT. You're going to copy into that folder. Now that that's done, you can open this LYT folder, and we're going to look for a specific file that is called connect_ecphp.inc.php. What we're going to do is we're going to change its name and we're going to delete the underscore and the ecphp part. So the file is going to end up being called connect.inc.php. Now you're basically done with the installation. There's one more extra step that you need to do each time you want to use the program to open it. You simply click on the icon of Dev Server 17, you double click on it, and then here on the toolbar, this icon is going to appear. What you need to do is to right click it, and here on servers, click on Start, Restart All Servers. We're going to click it and wait until there's a sound. Now you're going to open whatever browser you like to use, and you're going to copy this link into the search bar and click enter. And this is going to take you into Learning with Texts. The installation is done. Now what you need to do is to set up or define the language that you want to learn. As you see here, there is an option to do it, so you can just click on define the first language you want to learn. And this is the language settings wizard. As a disclaimer, I haven't tried to set up languages with different alphabets or scripts, such as Japanese or Arabic. I've only tried it with German, but there's a link in the description where there are instructions on how to work with those languages in case that's what you need. And again, if you need anything, I can take the time to see if I can help you install it. So we're basically going to choose our language name. I'm going to say Spanish, for example. And here is where you need to define which dictionaries the app is going to use. What I recommend is that you use the spreadsheet that's going to be in the description, where you have templates for different languages, so you can fill these options without thinking too much. So for example, here in the spreadsheet, I'm going to look for Spanish, and I see that one of the recommended dictionaries is Word Reference. So we just copy this text and we paste it here in dictionary one. Dictionary two is optional. And in case the spreadsheet doesn't have an answer for you, you can choose whatever dictionary that you want. You're going to have to test it. But basically what you do is, for example, here on Word Reference, if I look a word up in Spanish, like casa, I have this page, and I just simply copy this link, and then the word itself that you used as an example, you just delete it and replace it for three numeral signs. That's going to tell the program that each time it looks up a word, it has to replace it in that link, and so you can use any dictionary that shows you the word that you looked up in the link. We can also copy here from the spreadsheet the Google Translate link to paste here. You can choose the text size, and then you see that in the spreadsheet you also have the rest of the settings for Spanish. It says just leave character substitutions in default, so we don't change anything. Then for this option, we are just going to copy these characters. So you basically check each column of the spreadsheet and you fill these sections. Once you're done, you simply click on save, and that's your first language completely set up and ready to use. Remember that if you want to see how to create a text and add it to the program, or how to read and study with it, you can check out my other video where I went over it in detail. Just as a quick reminder, you can just go to my texts, you can add a new text, you can copy the title of a news piece, for example, and some text, and then you can copy the link, you can even add tags and the audio, you choose the language, and then you save and open it, and you can start working with the program as I showed you in my other video. As you can see now, if we click on a word like producir, we can just see the dictionary that we saved when we set up the language. You can see that it means to produce or to make, and you can just add that definition here and save it, and yeah, just keep working with it. This is all that you need to do. When you're done using the program, you can simply click down here, right click it and choose exit, and that's it. Or you can just turn off your computer and everything's going to be saved automatically. I've only explained how to do this for Windows PCs because that's what I know about, but in this website you can also read the instructions in case you want to install it on a Mac or on a computer that uses Linux. You really just have to follow each step, and it's going to be very similar to the Windows installation, but maybe a few things are going to be different. I hope this was helpful to you or that you found it interesting. This is an amazing tool, so in case you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comments. And again, if you like this video, you can leave a like, or you can subscribe to my channel for more language learning videos. And that's it for today. I'll see you in the next one.